knows
that I ain't going.
Going nowhere.
I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should have known it. I wasn't going.
What's up, YouTube? Makeup Janelle here. If this is your first time to my channel, welcome. What's up? How you doing? I have gained so many new subscribers over the past month or two, and I'm just so grateful and so thankful for you guys. If you are not subscribed to my channel, this is the good time where you can just, yep, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Today, I've really been wearing this brownish, like smoky eyeshadow look, and I'm gonna show you guys. We're going to do full glam today. Like, I think I'm even about to underpaint a little bit, so we're getting ready to do some full glam, which I'm very excited about. And I'm just going to talk to you guys talk my way through this glam, honestly. Okay, y'all know I always, if this is your first time to my channel, I usually have music playing in my ear. Okay, so my skin is already prepped. I use the Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cream for my moisturizer. And today for primer, I use the Patrick Star One Size Primer, which a lot of people use very incorrectly. I'm going to show you guys how to use it. If you don't know, clearly I have it in my big kit. This is what it looks like. It comes in a whole tube type of thing. So you're only supposed to put like a pea size amount in your fingers, and you're supposed to warm it up. Like, warm it up in your fingers and then you work it into your skin. But you wanna make sure that where you're putting it, your skin is dry. That's how you use that. Do I wanna underpaint today? I think I do wanna underpaint today. I was watching this beautiful video that Patrick Ta was actually doing, and he was underpainting and it looked so good. I was like, oh, my next face I need to underpaint. So I think that's what I'm gonna do today. As I grab my life of makeup products here. Okay, so I'm gonna start by bronzing my face with my, this is my Black Opal Cream Stick Foundation in the shade Hazelnut. I think we just gonna just go right in and just, you know, see where the makeup gods take us. I haven't really laid my edges because I usually lay my edges like after I'm done with my makeup, so I think I'm gonna do that. Okay, so I'm gonna take, as I get makeup everywhere, I'm gonna take my cream stick foundation and just get a little brush here. Excuse me if you guys hear my neighbors outside, they're a little loud, but, and we're just gonna tap into that. And like I said, we're doing underpainting, so we're starting with our bronzer and liquid blush first. If it looks too much, it's okay. It's makeup, y'all. It could be blended out. Okay, so yep, we're just gonna start going in with bronzer here. And I actually think I'm gonna mix like a bronzer shade and a contour shade at the same time. And we're gonna go take this all around the perimeter because we like a nice bronzy situation. Sometimes I feel like when you underpaint, you use less foundation because most of your face is already kind of covered. I look crazy, but it's okay. You don't have to underpaint, okay? Most of the time I do not underpaint. I start with foundation first, but I'm gonna show you guys how I do it today. We're gonna use so much liquid blush, I can't wait, man. I'm gonna go along our jawline here. Yep, just along the jawline. If it looks crazy, no worries. It's makeup, it can be blended out. Sometimes too, with bronzer, if you feel like your foundation is too light, bronzer can really help kind of warm everything up and kind of help your foundation not look so light if you feel like it is too light. Okay, so I'm gonna actually add this NYX Pro Fix. Let me show you, this is what it looks like. I see it here, hold on. Boom, that's what it looks like. This is the NYX Pro Stick Correcting Concealer Stick thing. I don't even know what shade this is. Oh, Deep Walnut. Okay, so usually when you're contouring, like this shadow right here, that's what you want your contour to be. I really don't contour much. I really bronze and add warmth to my face. But I'm gonna just, I don't think I'm gonna dot this on. I'm actually gonna take a small amount on the back of my hand and kinda, but you see how like that's a really cool color? Like that's a cool shade. I don't wanna bronze my whole face with this because I'm gonna be looking, it's gonna be looking a little crazy. So I'm just gonna swatch a little bit on the back of my hand. I'm actually gonna use this for the eyeshadow a little too quick. We're gonna get there. And I'm taking that same brush and I'm tapping into that color. And this color is only gonna stay like right in that shadow part, like right there. I am not going to really, but you see how that looks like a shadow now? Like, y'all don't be knowing the difference between bronzing and contouring. So yeah, this, cause it is giving, when we think of contour, we think of like drag, for real. Like that's where that kind of, that's where that comes from, you know? That's why they be looking so snatched, because they be contoured. So I'm just kind of meshing that right in. Ooh, child, it looked like a lot, but it's okay. But yeah, we're just gonna keep that right there. And I kind of just meshed it into the bronzer. Okay, I like that. Now, liquid blush, because who do we think we are if we don't apply liquid blush? Oh, do I want to be like baby doll pink? I don't know. I don't know. Or do I want to be like, because I dropped my liquid blush on the floor. I don't know what I want to do with my life. Do I want to be like Barbie doll or do I want to be like Mauvey? I usually go for the Barbie doll though. I'm doing some hard thinking because I mean, I'm gonna mix two blushes together. It's either like on the mauve side, hold on, there we go. Or like on the baby doll pinky side. My life, this is the probably one of the toughest decisions. We're not gonna be Barbie. We just gonna be a little mauve. Okay, so I'm gonna take this e.l.f. liquid blush in the shade, what is the name of this? Suave Mop, period. And we're gonna mix both of these together. We're going to take this shade at the top here. And yes, I'm probably gonna pack it on. Boom. And now we're gonna take the, another, why is this so, this is dirty, I don't like this. Not what I want. Okay, now we're gonna take the another e.l.f. blush in the shade Dusty Rose. And we're just gonna, what am I, cause this song is so good. Yeah, I don't know why, I'm just gonna minister right now to you guys. If anybody, if you are like struggling, feeling like you're worthy and you're chosen, I'm gonna give you a song to listen to. I'm gonna put it up here too. But it's called Chosen by Madison Ryan Ward. This song has been, it made me cry the other day. Like, because I feel like as you go through life and as you go through trials, you kind of feel like you're not worthy of certain things. And I'm in a place in my life where I'm doing a lot of discovering and a lot of shifting and a lot of figuring out my life a little bit. And I think one of the biggest purpose of me going through all this is to get closer with God and really believing that I'm worthy of certain things. And what? We're chosen. Okay. Okay. So I think I'm going to wipe off that same brush that we were using because I don't feel like picking up another brush. I ain't even going to lie to y'all. To blend out my liquid blush. I really be holding my hair like I got long hair. And baby, this is gonna go like all up under here. Chosen, like just remember baby, you're chosen. Like if you don't know, you're chosen. Please keep that in mind. You're chosen at all times. Okay, so I'm loving how this mixed in with my bronzer. Ooh, child, this is, I maybe have needed this glam today. When I do glam for like batch content, like I'm doing today, my glam be coming out so thing pretty. Because no worries, we're gonna put concealer up under here. Now, is my sponge wet? It is. Okay. I'm loving this. Now we're gonna go ahead and add our foundation. My foundation, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Although, I have been tempted to use the new Huda, the new Huda Beauty foundation, the flawless filter or whatever it's called. I have been kind of tempted to, you know, try some new things in my life. You know, this is great. When a client sends you a deposit, God be working, y'all. When I say God be working, God be working. So I put a little bit, normally my foundation goes on the palm of my hand, but I put it on a little plate here because I kind of want to thin it out, like, because we're going to pick up a little bit at a time. Yeah, we're going to thin it out just a little bit. I'm trying to keep the back of my hand clean, but it's not. It's going to get dirty. It's going to get dirty. You know, it's going to get dirty. We're going to take a sponge, and I'm going to spray my sponge with, because it was damp, but I feel like it wasn't damp enough. So I'm just going to take a little bit of foundation at a time. We're just going to boom, 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 just tap into our foundation. Pick up a little bit at a time. A lot of y'all be going in with the foundation. Start with a little bit, work your way up, okay? And we just gonna tap and blend. This is why I said when you underpaint, it kind of helps you use less foundation. Cause you're really just, the foundation is like blending everything in. Like so, and blend in that bronzer. And I'm using like the smallest amount, like a little bit. I need to try this technique on my clients. Sometimes it don't work like that though. Like some clients I can't underpaint with, and I feel like some I can, but I don't know, I might have to try it. This is like the greatest thing to me about makeup is that you can always try different stuff, you know? Makeup to me just never, it fascinates me every time. It's so fascinating to me and it never gets boring. As my loud neighbor pulls up, y'all, my bad. I don't know. When I'm not doing nothing, it's quiet outside. As soon as I start filming, everybody just want to be outside talking. And it's annoying. Do y'all see this? And then when we put our concealer on, oh my God, honey, so pretty. We're like moving out of, you know, summer into, I guess, autumn now. Well, spring, is it spring or autumn? I don't know. Anyways, we're moving into the cooler seasons and my foundation is gonna change. So that's what I'm looking at right now. I'm like, damn, does my foundation still match? I think it does. I've used the least amount of coverage and it looks so good. Sometimes I really only focus the coverage where I need it. Instead of, when I start with foundation first, that's when I feel like I put a lot on. Cause we're putting it everywhere, you know? Okay, we're gonna pick up a little bit more and kind of blend our forehead a little bit. Just kind of mesh everything in, like so. I have been loving the Hourglass concealer. This was a gift for myself, and I'm like, ooh. This is in the shade Flax, F-L-A-X. And, would I consider this brightening? No. Okay, so we're gonna focus it there. No, it's a little bright, it's a little bright. Boom. It's like one side of my face just always looks different. I feel like I need Botox to like balance out my face. Is it just me or does anybody else think their face is crooked? Okay. Boom. Let's make sure the nose is straight here. I've seen different ways. People have started contouring their nose different ways, but y'all just do what works best for you, please. Don't get so hung up on like what you see on TikTok and stuff. Like, if it works for you, just keep doing that. Now, if you just see something and you're like, ooh, I wanna try it that way. Okay, try it that way. Put some right there. I'm trying to debate. See, because I've been thinking about stuff that I've been seeing on TikTok. And I'm like, I know I don't do my makeup that way, but no, we gonna keep it like that because I was gonna put it all over. I don't do it that way. Okay, so we are gonna rehydrate our face with the NYX matte finish. My music is making me feel happy. I'm on my cycle. So, you know, the hormones be hormoning. And I've been having to listen to music to keep my spirits up, you know? It's safe to say. Okay. Let's work on blending this concealer out. We're gonna start here. Start here. Then I'm gonna start working on the forehead part. So you don't wanna bring your concealer too far up. You're gonna make your forehead look too big. You kinda wanna keep your concealer right in the center. Like that. So I'm just tapping and tapping. Tapping. I gotta keep track of the time. I do have a client, but we're doing good. Cause we're like, once we set our makeup, we're like almost done, you know? New love. Y'all probably like, girl, stop singing. But I can't do makeup in the dead quiet. I feel like something's missing. And you know, YouTube be flagging with makeup with music in the background, so I ain't got time. Okay. How y'all like that? Y'all like that? Okay, so now we're gonna start blending out this under eye concealer. So you kinda wanna keep your concealer in the center, but this is where like the blush is about to go away, so I'm probably gonna put on more liquid blush, just letting you know. And I do like to kind of shape my concealer to kind of snatch my face a little bit. Yep, just like that. I'm gonna flip my sponge over to the side where we kind of had our foundation on it and just start blending that out. Is it just me or the glam is starting to glam? Y'all see it? I'm gonna let this other part kind of sit a little bit longer because you know, the longer you let your concealer sit, the thicker it'll get and the more coverage it'll give you, because I'm gonna add more liquid blush because it's my face and I want to. So yeah, we're gonna blend out like around the nose a little bit. Try to get in between the little crevices over there. Y'all, it's giving snatchy snatch. Okay, it's giving snatchy snatch. This is my bad side of my face. This side, I feel like I gotta snatch all the way up. Cause it just, it just goes down and I don't like it. Like, I just, this whole side of my face just don't be doing what it's supposed to be doing. Okay, so we're just gonna keep blending. If you feel like your makeup looks bad, that means you did not blend enough. So I need you to blend until your wrist falls off. And then we're gonna flip over again and kind of, okay, so while our concealer is sitting, we're gonna add more blush because why not? Why not? I think I'm gonna take the, what is it? Suave Mauve. Yeah, we're gonna do some more Suave Mauve here. Boom. Listen. Do I wanna use a brush or do I wanna use my sponge? No, we're gonna use, we're gonna go back to the brush. Okay. It's just, when I be doing batch content, I be taking so much time to do my makeup, and when you take your time, I know it takes forever, it just comes out so good though. When I be rushing, it don't come out this good. Okay. I'm loving this. It's giving what I needed to give. Whatever's left over, we're gonna blend in that concealer to like our bronzer. Oh, we're very excited. I'm gonna let this concealer sit a little bit longer while I mix together a little concoction of powders. I'm taking, what is this, makes me think about my future husband. Okay, this is the Banana Bread Easy Bake powder by Huda in the shade Banana Bread. Oh, when I get married, I think this might be like the first song I dance to. I'll put it up here for you guys. I'm not really a big, I'm not really a big yellow, like yellow, loose powder, translucent powder type of gal. I really don't think yellow complements me. So sometimes I like to mix a yellowish powder mixed in with a pinky powder because I feel like my undertone's not yellow. It's more maybe on the peachy side a little bit. So when I mix the powder, I mix the Banana Bread and I mix the Ben Nye Pretty Pink. Oh, I think that's what it's called. Don't let me lie, it's in my kit. Yeah, I think it's Pretty Pink. I like to mix that together for myself. So, okay. So we let this concealer sit a little bit longer. And we're gonna keep it like right here. That didn't feel like this. That we both need to grow. I'm gonna get on y'all nerves, but it's okay. I can love you with grace. Whatever left over, I'm just gonna take it on my eye and kind of blend that out. Admit that I'm insane for you. I'm looking at this back here. There's a bit of a glare, but I think it's okay. We're just gonna keep moving. I'm not gonna overthink this video because I'll be like, ugh! I'll be overthinking a lot of like stuff in my life. So we're just gonna keep blending, clearly. Okay, so we're gonna grab our powder puff and I mixed the two powders together. And so we're gonna tap a little bit of that off. Like so. Tap most of it off. I ain't gonna lie. Tap most of it off. Like, it's the smallest amount on here. Tap that shit off. You don't want to start with too much powder. And again, we're gonna blend one more time before we set. Because we kind of want to avoid as many creases as possible. Side note, your makeup will never not crease. So if you think you can do something to make it not crease, you let me know what you try because It's makeup. It's makeup on skin. It's gonna crease, okay? I'm gonna try to keep my eye up until I, oh, see, okay, okay. And then now we're gonna set. I'm so glad I didn't mix like yellow. I just don't care for yellow powder. I don't really care for yellow powder on any complexion, actually. I just don't like it. Like when I see, you know, deeper skin complexions and it just be so yellow, I'm like, what the hell? Like, I get that you're trying to be bright and all, but I just don't care for the yellow powder. It just doesn't sit well in my spirits. But that's just me. That's just me. That's my song too. Okay, so now we're just setting our little wonderful T-zone area here. And you see how our blush is fading? That means we're gonna add more blush. That's what that means. We're gonna add more blush. And I'm gonna set my forehead. Try to look up and like set your concealer. It's okay if it's not perfect, you guys. Makeup is not meant to be perfect, just letting you know. Like, makeup is just, it's not meant to be perfect. You could try to get it as close as possible, but you know, as long as we look good in a picture, I think that's all that matters, you know? Because our skin's not perfect. We have like imperfections with our skin, so don't like expect your makeup to be like perfect, perfect. When you're baking, try not to like apply so much pressure when you're laying down your bake, okay? We just wanna gently like lay that powder down. This is me trying to get my nose straighter than what it is. Whatever's left over, I am gonna bake here. I'm just picking up a little bit at a time and just kind of laying down some powder. See, we're just gonna, I feel like one side always look different, but I guess as long as they look together. That's okay. This side can go down, this side can go up, just to kind of make things match, you know? Okay, I like this. Now we're gonna go ahead and add powder bronzer and powder blush. Powder bronzer is the Juvia's Place palette in the shade Tan. Gonna get a little angle brush here, and I think I'm just gonna maybe go in with both colors. Sometimes I only use one depending on my complexion. And we're just gonna continue to snatch our lives away here. You know what, today may not be a good filming day for me, but anyways, camera's acting funny. I went ahead and did my brows off camera because my camera was dripping, and I really just want to show you guys the eyeshadow look. So yes, I already did my powder bronzer. I'm looking for my blush, which I can't find it. It's like a small little blush. Oh, here it is. This blush was, it's a Makeup Forever blush. I don't know the name of it because it doesn't have a name on it. It literally just looks like this. So, sorry. Any blush that you prefer works, okay? I'm waiting for my air to click off. It should click off in a second. Yep, look at God, okay. So now I'm just gonna add some blush on because our blush has faded, as you can see. Y'all see it coming together? Okay, let's get into this look, because that's really what this whole tutorial is about. Okay, so that same, I feel like I'm yelling because my music's loud, y'all. Sorry. That same NYX stick that we use to, you know, bring out our contour, we're gonna use that as eyeshadow. We're gonna use it as eyeshadow, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. Okay, we're gonna take it and literally put it everywhere. As my little sister calls. Hello. Filming a YouTube video. I'm filming this brown eyeshadow look. Okay. I gotta get my ducks in a row. I gotta monetize. Yeah, it's like a smoky chocolate brown look I've been wearing, and I've been wanting to recreate it for YouTube. Oh, blue eyeliner, YouTube. My sister wants me to put blue eyeliner on. All right. Blue eyeliner, you guys. That's what she just told me to do. Okay. Okay, love you. Bye. Great. You know what? Let me express myself very quickly. Damn it! Is she calling again? She's calling again, you guys. Hold on. Okay. So, let me explain this. I put the whole color, as you guys seen, put it on my whole eyelid, and now I'm just kind of blending it out. I'm reading this book called The Seven Laws of Love. Yes, The Seven Laws of Love, right? And it teaches you like how to love from every perspective, like as a friend, as a spouse. It really teaches you love. And my sister called me, and I'm being impatient a little bit, but I have to kind of rewire my thinking and just be like, you know what? I have to really be grateful for those moments, because some people don't have their siblings. Some people, you know, you just never know. So thank you for calling me, girl. I'll see you tomorrow. But yes. Okay. So now I'm just kind of blending out that cream. You see how pretty that is? It's like we did a whole brown smoky look without really doing much. And this has really been my eyeshadow look for the past couple of times I've done my makeup too. Okay. So, and like it does it. And it's been doing it for me. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. This is my bad side, but it's okay. And I'm just kind of blending out the edges first. Instead of just diving into the center of it, I'm just blending out the edges. Blending out the edges here. And then I do kind of go over the lid just a little bit. I've been loving this eyeshadow look. Like, it's really been doing it for me. I do put a little bit at the bottom. So I'm just gonna take a little thin little line. Boom, at the bottom, like that, a little bit. We're gonna blend it out anyway, y'all. We're gonna blend it out, and we have to set it with the eyeshadow. So now I'm taking a little pencil brush and just blending out the bottom without messing up my contacts. And it's okay if it's not perfect, because we still gotta add a little bit more. Now I'm taking the Makeup Shayla Wifey palette, because the colors are still kind of the same in there. And I'm gonna set like the eye with we're gonna figure that out in 2 seconds. I don't know yet. I don't know which direction I wanna go in, just to be honest with you. Let me find what brush I wanna use. I need to get like a thick, well, we're gonna just do a regular eyeshadow brush, because it does crease a little bit because it's concealer and you have to set it with a powder. So I think I'm gonna take this brown shade here And I'm gonna set the whole eye with that. Taking just a regular flat eyeshadow brush and just tap that color on there. Yeah, just like so. And this is how I've been creating this super pretty brown eyeshadow look without really doing much. It's so pretty. Yep, we're just gonna keep packing that on. Like so. I am gonna put a little bit of black eyeliner on and like smudge it out too, but it like, I have to like put a lot of eyeshadow like in my crease a little bit because I do have hooded lids and I wanna make sure that doesn't move. And it's okay, we're gonna blend out the harsh edges, you guys. We're gonna blend out the edges, so don't worry about it. I'm gonna take the tip of that same brush and just put a little bit at the bottom here. I love bottom eyeshadow. I just feel like it connects the pieces of your eyeshadow together. I am winging it out just a little bit because it's just my personal preference. You do not have to do this. Yep, we're just gonna keep going. Like so. And we're gonna still blend. We're gonna blend. It's okay. If it looks a little not blended, it's because we just need to blend. I need to find a clean brush. You know what would help me if I laid out all my brushes, but I'm just gonna ramble through them like this and find a clean brush. Yep, found a clean brush. There we go. So I'm just gonna take a clean brush and just blend out the edges like that. Just blend out edges like so. And y'all, we have on like, that's it. Like, we gotta put on a little eyeliner, but that's really it. It's just so pretty and I'm like loving it. We are gonna take, as my ear pods fall out, some black eyeliner and we're gonna smudgy smudge just a little bit. So pretty. It's kind of giving 90s a little bit. It's okay if it's not perfect because we're gonna blend it out anyway and we're gonna put lashes on. Okay, I'm gonna take that same pencil brush and just, I feel like there's something on there, and just smudge out that black. Just smudgy, smudgy, smudge. Pretty. Pretty, pretty. Oh, I'm closing the wrong eye. Janelle, get it together. Okay. I love a good smudgy liner. Because it don't look like super, super harsh. Like it's just a black line running through. Going through your eye. Okay, so we're gonna put a little bit at the bottom. And you could have did maybe a brown liner at the bottom. I'm doing black. And we're doing like a pretty matte lip. Oh, I can't wait. Okay. Okay, So now I'm gonna just smudgy smudge the bottom like so. My contacts are bothering me. Hold on. Ooh, y'all, the contacts be like, I gotta be careful. Okay. Pretty. The lashes of choice I'm using today are the VLux Crystal Glow lashes. This is what they look like. How pretty. In the style Marquise. Thank you. Shout out to iEnvy for sending me these lashes because, woo, you can't go wrong with lashes. This song is great. I don't know why I put them scissors down, so I'm gonna need them again. Okay, so the thing about these, okay, I kind of know. I didn't know where the front or the back was on the lashes. I'm looking. Okay, so be careful pulling your lashes off. You don't wanna. I do have to cut these because they're way too long. Let's grab some little scissors here. They are way too long for my eye. Remember, cut from the back of the lash, not the front of the lash. I'm trying to debate if I want to curl the lash. Because I always kind of curl my lashes. I think I'm gonna curl them just a little bit. Just a tad, even though they're kind of curled, but I like my lashes to go up, not straight out. Ugh. Sheesh, I done messed up the lash. Now I gotta figure out what's the front. Okay, so this is the back of this one. Okay. Some of these lashes, depending on the style, you kind of can't tell the front from the back. Oh my God, I just got it mixed up. You guys. I think I just messed up. Because this is this eye, I think. I just got it messed up. I think I cut the wrong ends of the lash. My life right at this very second is very, no, that's fine. All right, we're just gonna do it like that. Effort. Because I just mixed up the whole lash. I'm gonna curl it a little bit because I feel like the curl on it is a little strange. I'm gonna curl it like right at the where the band is. I'm gonna curl it just a little bit. Ray. Sometimes I curl my natural lashes too. It just depends. I'm loving this song. The song is great, okay. The glue I'm gonna be using is the duo glue, the white and green one. I'm debating if I wanna cut more of this lash off, but anyways. Okay, motorcycle guy. Interrupting, see what I'm saying? You're always interrupting my YouTube videos. Like, when I'm doing nothing, it's just so quiet. And then when I'm just trying to be great, that's when all the distractions come in life, right? I think that's just the way life is. And I don't put way too much glue on this lash. But it's okay. It's all right. Just gonna put some glue. Way too much, no, way too much, girl. I said, brain. And while that's percolating, we're gonna go ahead and do our lippy lip because we're going to use one of my favorite matte lip colors, and that is what is this called? Hold on, I don't wanna lie. I'm gonna tell y'all what it's called in 2 seconds once I find the lip liners I wanna use, which is not what I'm picking up. Well, I guess we'll use this one. This is a lip liner from Maybelline, the Lifter Liner? I didn't know this was called Lifter Liner, in the shade Let's Bounce. When I bought this, I thought it was gonna be a little bit more brown, but it wasn't. It's a little bit more on the, it has a little bit of pink to it. So I was like, oh. Now I'm gonna take this dark brown lip liner. And this is what I'm gonna use to overline my lips. This is the NYX lip liner in the shade dark brown. So I'm overdue for some lip filler. I've been getting lip filler for like 2 years. If it looks scary, don't. Don't worry, because you know what? We're gonna blend it out. See, it ain't that bad. I'm gonna take like a little lip applicator and just blend out my lip liner a little bit more. Like that. Boom. Now we're gonna take this Morphe liquid lipstick in the shade Wifey, which I am manifesting right now, right in the middle. So pretty. So I went ahead and popped my lashes on because I really didn't think I was gonna like them, but they're all right. They're all right. I usually don't, my style of lash is a cat eye, and this is not a cat eye lash. So, you know, we're just gonna get a little used to it. And I feel like this, like I like my eyes, I like it to go up. So I feel like I'm, you know, debating on whether to switch these lashes out, but y'all may like them. So. Oh, I had on the lashes where you put them under your lash extensions. I had them on and the glue is still kind of on my eye. So, okay, we're just gonna do some finishing touches. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna move away from the eyes really quickly. And we're just gonna do some last minute touch-ups, which, is this clean? I don't know if this is clean. We're gonna dust away this powder. And I think I'm gonna brighten my under eye too. How y'all like it? Is it giving glam? Is it making your day? Is my glam making your day? Please let me know. Okay, so we are gonna brighten my under eye just a little bit. I'm gonna take my Maybelline matte pressed powder in the shade 310. And I'm tapping my powder puff in it. My lashes are sticking together. And I'm just gonna tap up under here. like so. Like that. Do the same thing to the other side. As y'all can see, I'm a matte girly. Like, matte me out, baby. Because when the natural oils start sinking in, the face is not gonna be oily anymore. So we're just pressing that in. I'm not even like a big highlight person. I don't really like a lot of highlight. Sometimes I do and sometimes I don't. Okay, so we're gonna grab some mascara. If I have one over here. Okay, yeah, we're just gonna do Great Lash. Great Lash, some waterproof Great Lash. This is what we're gonna do. And add some mascara to the bottom of our lashes here to kind of help our false lashes blend in with our natural lashes. And this kind of helps close that gap in between your lashes too. Okay. These lashes make my eyes, shape my eyes so differently from what I'm used to. And I think that's what I have to get used to. But I picked the style, so I kind of knew what I was getting into, okay? As another motorcycle just interrupts my video. Oh God, it's the same one. It's the same effing motorcycle, but we're not, we're just gonna be patient. And we're gonna do some bottom mascara. Oh, is it so pretty? It's so pretty, isn't it? And it literally was the easiest eyeshadow look ever. I am getting mascara everywhere, but it's okay. I know. Okay, so this is pretty much the finished look. We're letting this mascara dry. I do need to go lay down my edges, but this is so, let me, you know, be pretty for a second. And fun fact about me, I don't like posing and I don't like taking pictures. I like to do videos, but not pictures. I am not a picture girly. I feel like I look like a deer in the headlights when it comes to taking pictures. So if you ever see me take a picture, it's because they got one good one. Okay, one good one, that's it. I am trying to pinch these lashes together and just push this side up. This whole side of my face be droopy, so, you know, just trying to pinchy pinch. Okay, let me know what you guys think of this brown, smoky, glam look in the comments. If there is another type of look that you guys want me to try, please let me know in the comments. If you have not subscribed to my channel, make sure you do so. I'm still gonna be coming you guys. I'm coming back with my weekly vlogs, but it's been a minute since I sat down and did glam with you guys. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this. Made it a little long. The tutorial was a little long, but I hope you guys enjoy. Until next time.
But you should've known it, I wasn't going.